If you go to a doctor for a health checkup, they'll definitely give you a report to tell you how you're doing from a health perspective. But did you know that WordPress also offers a health check? It absolutely does. And similar to how you see on the screen, your website's health might be failing. So in this video, I'm going to give you the most essential tips you can follow very, very easily to improve your website's health and also improve website functionality, security, and performance all at the same time. Easy to follow tips, all for free. So let's get started. The first thing to look out for when checking your WordPress health score is to get better hosting. Hosting is one of the most important decisions you'll take when fixing or improving your website or checking its health score or performance. Because your hosting provider affects the website security, the performance, all the backend features that are invisible to you are also dependent on the host, because whatever technological platform they're using is what WordPress is dependent on to actually perform at its best. So if your hosting provider isn't great, the health check should be the least of your concerns, because ultimately you'll run into more bigger problems in the future if your host can't solve it when it comes to performance, security, and tons of other features. Now, hosting itself is a big decision, and it can get very technical to understand what hosting provider is good, was not great. So if you don't want to get into a technical discussion, the easiest answer for you is to just pick from the three of the top hosting providers that WordPress recommends and we recommend as well. The answers are Bluehost, SiteGround, and Hostinger. You'll find links on the screen and also in the link in the description of this video to all three providers. They're absolutely fantastic for beginner websites, small business websites, websites for solopreneurs, and all that good stuff. So make sure to check those hosting providers out. These are all fantastic hosting providers when it comes to security, performance, and all the other features, technological features that you might not be aware of. All these hosting providers are absolutely fantastic on all three grounds, and you'll never run into problems when it comes to any of the health checks and of course the other problems that I mentioned. The next thing to look out for if you're trying to improve your health check score is to install an SSL certificate or move to the HTTPS version of your website. Let me demonstrate. So this is a simple website. You see the URL is businesswebsite.com, and if I click here, you'll see businesswebsite.com. Connection is secure. This is the default behavior for most websites. They come equipped with an SSL certificate. That means the connection between the browser that the user has and the website is secure. Now let's look at the opposite end of the spectrum. This is a website which does not use HTTPS. So you Google what this does in Chrome browser and every other browser as well, just displays a not secure sign. If a user clicks on it, they'll see your connection to this site is not secure. Now what this does is erode the trust of your user that they have in your website. So if you have this, users are scared to pass on their personal information, sign up for email lists, and make payments on your site. It's not a great practice overall to have on your site, and Google also demotes your website in the search results if you don't have an SSL certificate. Now the good news is there's easy ways to actually migrate your site to HTTPS if you have an existing website. And if you don't have an existing website, you're starting a website, just go to the links in the description, sign up for any of the hosting providers that I mentioned, and by default they already install a free SSL certificate for you without any cost. So they'll install it for you, they'll configure it for you, you just build your website and everything will be working from an SSL perspective right from the get-go. No manual work required. And if you already have a website, we have a lot of tutorials on our website or on our YouTube channel as well already, which describe how to actually migrate your website to HTTPS or using an SSL certificate. So I'll place it on screen and also link in the description. So after you watch this video, go watch it. It's an absolutely simple process. You'll be done in a couple of hours. All right, now on to the next tip. The next thing to keep in mind to get a great health score is to always keep WordPress updated. Onto my screen here, WordPress does a great job of notifying you whenever there's a new version out. So you'll see on this website, WordPress 6.4.2 is available, please update now. This is a persistent message. You can't get rid of it unless you update. So if you're just logged into your website, you'll always see this on the screen. So it's a great nudge to actually just go and update. And you can also go into the dashboard and the update section and find out here. But if you're just accessing the website anywhere, just click the Please update now button, keep a backup of your website ready, and then update to the latest version. It takes a few minutes of time and it's usually very, very safe. Nothing usually happens on your website, and it gives you all the great benefits, new security features, better performance, all that good stuff, and also will improve your health score overall on your WordPress health check. On to the next tip. The next thing to do to improve your WordPress health score is to keep your plugins and themes updated. Onto my screen here once again, this is a section in my website for plugins, install plugins. This is where you'll find all the plugins that are installed on your website as well. And as you can see, a lot of plugins I have installed are not updated to the latest version. If you don't do this, then you will not receive the perfect health score. And updating plugins is actually very, very easy. Just click the update now button. For example, if I go here and I just do this update now, it'll automatically start updating. You should also do this for themes. So by going into appearance and themes, you can find out all the themes that require an update and update your themes as well. Now, when you're talking about plugins and themes, one more thing to remember, which is also very important, is to delete plugins that you don't use. For example, you see here, I'm using the WP Code Pro version on my website, but the light version is also installed. That means the light version is absolutely not required for me on the site right now. So what I should be doing and what you should be doing as well on your website is whenever you find a plugin that, hey, I'm not using this plugin, why is it installed? Just delete it like this, click OK. It'll take a few seconds and be deleted off your website. This keeps your website secure because old plugins can also have vulnerabilities. So why take the hassle, delete the old plugins that you're not using on your site and make sure that plugins are actually updated. You can also enable automatic updates for plugins. So what you can do is select the plugin, for example, here, and go here, and just enable auto updates and click apply. And what will happen is all those plugins, whenever there's a new version out of that plugin, it'll automatically be updated to the latest version. That's fantastic. So you don't have to go into your website and update plugins manually. Now, this is a personal choice, but it's highly recommended that you update your plugins to the latest version already for the health check and also for security updates, for better performance and more features that the plugin authors actually put out. So make sure to update to the latest version of all the plugins and delete the plugins that you don't use. And automatic plugin updates is something up to you, but I'll highly recommend that you turn it on. On to the next tip. The next thing to keep in mind to get a great WordPress health score is to use the latest version of PHP and MySQL or whatever database system you're using. PHP is the language in which WordPress is written in, and MySQL or MariaDB is the database structure where all the data is stored. Now, similar to how you have versions of WordPress, there are versions of PHP that are released by the entity or the organization that manages PHP and MySQL. But if you're not using the latest version, you are missing out on a lot of security features, performance benefits, and tons of other things that make your website fast and better. So what you should do is ensure that the latest version of PHP, whatever is supported by WordPress, is what your website is using. For example, if I go here on my screen, and if you use or try out your website or build your website on a local server using this application called Local, you can instantly see the PHP version here. I'm using the PHP version 8.1.23, which is one of the more recent versions, and the database is MySQL 8.0.1.6. Now, in this server or in this application, which is used for local websites, I can actually just go to the dropdown and update or downgrade to the version of whatever PHP version I want. But this does not work the same way when it comes to actual live websites on hosting providers. In fact, I've actually demonstrated how to go and update to the latest version of PHP with Bluehost in a previous video. I'll place the clip on the screen, but the easiest way how you can ensure that you have the latest version of PHP running on your site and also the latest version of MariaDB or MySQL is to just do two things. First, you should go for a reputed hosting provider, because most reputed hosting providers will already be using the latest versions because it helps them actually build websites which are more secure and perform better. And once you've done this, all you have to do is reach out to the support team of whatever, let's say, hosting provider you're using, example Bluehost, SiteGround, or Hostinger, and just ask them, hey, am I using the latest version of PHP? Am I using the latest version of MySQL or MariaDB? And they'll confirm it. And if by chance, if you're not using the latest version, just request them to update your website to the latest version and it'll be taken care of by them automatically, or they'll direct you on how to do it yourself and it should be absolutely easy. Once again, it just takes a few clicks, but since there are so many different hosting providers, I can't possibly demonstrate how it happens or how it works with every different hosting provider. But as I said, I've already demonstrated how it works with Bluehost, so it should be very, very easy to follow and very similar in other hosting providers as well. On to the next step. The next thing to check to ensure that you have a great WordPress health score is to keep your REST API enabled. Now, it's a technical term, so let me clarify. If you haven't explicitly disabled the REST API, it is enabled by default. So you don't have to do anything. This is just a confirmation that if you have disabled it by, let's say, by chance, or you're trying something, then keep it enabled. What is the REST API? The REST API is, think of it as a service running in the background that allows third-party developers or third-party plugins or plugins to actually connect with external services. So let's say, for example, you have a dynamic widget on your site, which is fetching information for, let's say, Facebook, where you are displaying Facebook comments, or Instagram posts are embedded on your site. All this information is coming from Facebook and Instagram or Meta. So to be able to connect with these websites and services, the REST API is utilized. So if you disable it for some reasons, then you won't be able to use these services or any other third-party services which connect with your website. So it's absolutely critical that you keep them enabled. Otherwise, a lot of your plugins and other functionality on your website might be broken. Now, one thing to keep in mind that not every website needs it. For example, at WP Beginner, most of our websites don't have REST API enabled because we understand the technical limitations of it and we just keep disabled for security reasons, but we understand the implications of disabling them. If you're just a beginner, you're just using WordPress to build basic websites, then you don't need to worry. Most of the time, the REST API is enabled and you just have to keep it that way to get a great WordPress health score and also not enable or not affect any of the functionality on your website. On to the next tip. The next tip to keep in mind to ensure that you have a great WordPress health score and also functionality on your website is not affected, you have the best features of WordPress, is to ensure that most or most important PHP modules are active on your site. Now, it's a mouthful to understand what I'm saying, so let me clarify. As I already mentioned in the previous step, PHP is the language in which PHP or WordPress is actually written in. And similar to how WordPress has plugins, PHP also has different modules that can be enabled or disabled, which is usually under the control of your hosting provider. So technically, it's in the hands of the hosting provider to ensure that all the relevant PHP plugins are actually active. Now, you can't go and fix it without some technical help or technical understanding of what you're doing, or even ask for support from the hosting provider. So the best thing you can do is just go to the recommended hosting solutions that we recommended, Bluehost, Hostinger, and SiteGround. They are absolutely fantastic hosting providers, and most of the time, or I'd say not most of the time, almost all the time, they'll have all the relevant extensions for PHP already installed and active because they have using or they've been using the latest tech setups for WordPress. So you won't run into any trouble with the health check and also other features on your site. So the easiest way, as I said, the first thing I mentioned, if you just have a good hosting provider, many of these problems can be solved or will not occur in the first place if you just have a good hosting provider. So if you have a good hosting provider, all the relevant PHP extensions will be enabled. Otherwise, you can just ask from your hosting provider's support, hey, are these or am I using the most important extensions? Can you double check? And they'll be able to answer your question in a relevant way. On to the next tip. The next thing to double check on your website and actually disable on your site is disabling your debug mode on WordPress if it is enabled. Now, what is a debug mode and why it's used or why would be on in the first place? Well, if you have a developer working on your website, debug mode is something that they use to debug the site. That means problems or solve or find out issues that have been happening because they are doing something custom on your site. It's actually important for developers, but sometimes in rare cases, developers, while they develop or deliver the website to you, they might have left it on. So what you need to do is disable the debug mode on your site because first of all, it uses more resources and also it gives out more information about your website than it's actually required. So just for security and also for better performance on your website, debug mode should be disabled on your site. If you don't know how to do this, how to check this, if you have not actually worked with a custom or developer to customize your site, you are probably good to go. Otherwise, what you can do is just ask the developer, hey, is debug mode enabled on my site? They'll be able to answer that question. And if it's enabled, they'll also be able to disable it as well. So easy peasy, simple fix, but very important fix for a great health check and also a secure website. On to the next step. The last tip I can give you for great health check and also for a fully functional website is to ensure that cron jobs can run on your site. Let me explain, also demonstrate what it means. Look at this website. I'm inside the tools section, inside the site health section, or not inside the site health section, I'm inside the cron events section. And these are all the automated events that are scheduled to run on your website. And you also see the amount of reoccurrence time or how frequently are they running on your site. So every 5 minutes, the search WP index controller is running. Every minute this is running. Every 5 minutes, once hourly, non-repeating, and some are running twice daily, some are running once daily. These are background activities that happen on your website, regardless of you if you're using your website or not. And these are absolutely critical to actually run your website and have a healthy website. So by chance, if cron jobs are disabled on your website, a lot of these things will start failing. So how do you ensure that these are enabled? If you go into the tools section, you might not find the cron event section because you, for that or to see all the cron jobs available on your site, need to go into your plugin section and install this plugin, which I have on my site. It's called WP Cron Troll. I'll leave a link in the description of this video. It's a free plugin. Go and install this. And by doing this, you'll be able to come here and see all the cron jobs working on your site. If you see any errors here, if you see, hey, something is failing, then you should contact your hosting provider and say, hey, my cron jobs are failing. Why is that happening? Make sure that cron jobs are enabled and cron is working perfectly on your site. Once this is done, you should have no issues with cron running on your site and you should have no problems with the health check and also your website should be fully functioning as well. All right, these are the tips I have for you for great WordPress health check and also have a healthy and fully functioning website. Which of these tips were new to you? Which of these tips are you going to apply to your site? And what are the results you expect? Let me know in the comments. Otherwise, like, share, subscribe, share the good karma out there. I'm Yuvraj and you're watching the most helpful WordPress related tutorials on the internet from WP Beginner. I'll catch you in the next video, hopefully very soon. Make sure to subscribe before you leave. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.